Hey everybody, it's Victa. It's time to continue your streak here in the Binding of Isaac Victa Afterbirth Plus series. Thank you everyone. The like streak counter is good to go. Along with today's meme of the day brought to you by Darentier or Darentier. I'm not exactly sure how you're going to pronounce it, but it's a good one. They said they just joined the community 3 days ago and they feel that this represents the great majority of us. I think it's true to a point, but I mean, you know, I'm not going to pass up, unless if I don't need it, like I'm not going to pass up Brimstone or Magic Mush for Sissy. And you know why that's great and accurate? Because Sissy is okay with that. There's going to be three Charlie, November, two Lima Golf. We've got tonsillitis. Well, the tonsil. I don't know why. To me, this Curse of Darkness looks even like way darker than usual. Fate, which is going to give us an Eternal Heart along with Flying. And then the Monster Manuel, which I will instantly replace with the Doctor's Remote because it actually does something. The Doctor's Remote's going to give us a an Epic Fetus shot, just a Predator missile. Tonsillitis, or the tonsil, whatever you want to call it, is going to give us a temporary orbital, I think, every time we get hit, something like that. I may be mixing it up with leprosy. But early flying here is going to be pretty darn huge, and protecting this Eternal Heart is also kind of important. I wouldn't mind getting the stopwatch. Let's not use our bomb. Let's use a Predator missile here. There we go. All right, so we have a Soul Heart. That insulates that Eternal Heart from possibly getting dunked before we can even get to the next floor. And, of course, that also gives us a lot of... it gives us a lot of motivation to keep our Devil Deal for the next floor as well. Now, something interesting about these Burning Isaacs that you may have caught a glimpse of it there, but if you notice, they actually flash red whenever they're on fire. And that is to signify they're taking damage. If you don't want to fight them, especially if you have flying like we do right now, you can totally just not fight them. Just stay in a safe place, and they'll actually just burn out, and they'll eventually be destroyed by the fire, which is pretty metal. But you know, all the same, it does keep you kind of safe. Make sure I don't see any tinted rocks. And yeah, I know people were getting on me for saying Olds and Victo, crazy Olds and Victo's seeing faces in the floor. Look. If I gotta go back and reload that seed on the other save file and take a high def screenshot of it, I'm gonna. All right, I only saw a select few of you on the forum saying that Zemigda's loot is mine. I don't see any faces on there. I haven't seen anyone who actually confirmed any faces, but I swear to you, there's faces. Wow, I'm just now realizing that shot speed is very, very good, but the problem with that is being overly good is that it's going to knock the ghosts around, and that's exactly what happened there. Mini haunts. And there goes our Soul Heart. Fantastic. That said, though, that's the only circumstance where having this much shot speed would be a bad thing this early on. And again, that is just due to the fact it's just classic Isaac physics. Or lack thereof. I don't know how all those shots just missed. Speaking of Magic Mush, we got it. Let's head on down. Now we're talking. All right, so we do have to be careful about the lack of protection for our red hearts. Game tried to just completely screw us right there. Because obviously we want to get our deal with the devil. Magic Mush is going to give us an all stats up, which is one of the best items in the game. Blah, blah, blah. Look, you already know what Magic Mush does. If you don't, it's one of the best items in the game. And quite frequently, I consider it the best item in the game based on the value that you get. You get HP, you get a damage multiplier, you get an all stats up. However, that does not include tears. And it also contributes towards the Fungi transformation, which is something that does exist, but no one really cares about. Including me. This is actually like a terrible room for us. Like really, really bad. We can get the barrels out of there. Yeah, there we go. That goes Wrath. All right, so we're still looking for a tinted rock or something that we can, again, insulate our red hearts here from damage. And if you're wondering, if you happen to be a newer player and you're wondering why is that such a big deal, it's because if we take any bit of red heart damage here on this floor, we lose the guaranteed deal with the devil. since we've taken damage. So that's why you'll very commonly hear streamers, YouTubers, or just Isaac players in general talk about they want to preserve the deal with the devil. That's the reason why your first goal on the first floor should be leaving the floor with at least one soul heart or more. Another reason why that's important is because obviously with the deal with the devil, we also are going to lose HP, assuming that there's like a takeable deal in there. Secret room might be to the right of here. Yeah. And what the soul hearts do, the soul hearts represent safety after taking all of your red hearts and converting it to devil deal items. So you won't immediately get yeeted out of a run just for taking a devil deal if you have a soul heart. So getting a soul heart after the first floor, it works twofold. It preserves your deal with the devil, and it also makes sure that Isaac doesn't die after taking a deal with the devil and getting rid of presumably all of his red hearts. He still has HP left over. So get rune bag here, which is going to drop us a random rune every now and then. Not really determined if it's like actually predetermined or not. I'm not entirely sure. It's none of my business. I let rune bag just kind of do all whatever it wants. I don't ask any questions. It just shows up, pays its bill on time, and it gets out. That's my kind of business right there. Wait for Monstro to jump before launching any sort of attacks like that, or like, say, the Priestess card. The other Monstro tooth, apparently. Basically, just wait until Monstro jumps in the air, and then you want to trigger your effect. We get yet another HP upgrade and more damage. I mean, I'm not going to complain about all this damage, but, like, you know, we don't need this amount of red hearts. Obviously, we could take Spirit of the Night here for spectral shots. I'm not going to, though, because we have flying already, and we don't need to. So it looks like we might be getting ourselves an angel run. Now, despite that, yes, I could have gone into the curse room in that locked door, but the thing is, we only have one key, and I didn't. It's probably a vault in there. It's not a dice room. I mean, I guess it technically could have been a dice room, but I'm not going to reroll this. This is a great start here with Magic Mush. And, you never want to give up your only key, and I didn't have to go back and buy more keys here. So not going into the curse room, while albeit debatable, it's not that detrimental to us as if it would be if we went into that locked room, presumably got nothing, and then just, you know, left without any keys there. So we potentially at the following item room is potentially at risk, which of course now, as I say that, trying to sound all analytical and smart and, you know, all that kind of stuff, we get a double key drop, so yeah. Not going to go red candle, it's completely not useless, or not useful. No, it's not happening, Crooked Penny. I don't care how many times you show your face. You burned me one too many times, that's it. I also feel like I'm like, popping into the microphone there, sorry about that. I do actually use a pop filter, but it's... Like, my P's and my A's are very, very powerful whenever I'm speaking. B's, kind of, I guess. Yeah, we'll take Damon's Tail. But definitely my P's and my A's, like the sharp A's. Those are two enunciations and pronunciations and inflections that are pretty strong whenever I'm in front of the microphone. The thing is moving at, like, actually Mach 10. There we go. The soul heart, get a couple more keys here. And we have found the boss, but not our item room. Honestly, I thought that grub was already dead. I don't know why. Since we're already here, I'm not going to skip the item room. I just want to go back and go after Stain. We're not going to use Doctor's Remote until it starts doing the shots. Because it is possible that it could retract back into the ground before we get a chance to actually damage it. There we go. And alternatively, you can also use these red poops here in the middle of this room as a buffer zone. We do get an angel deal. We get Mr. Dolly, which gave us range and tears, which is an excellent item. Okay, we get duality, which is certainly something. I mean, there's no reason, I guess, for us not to take duality. Purple fires, by the way, they can only be destroyed by bombs or explosions, and they will fire homing projectiles at you, unlike the blue fires, which do not do anything except just sit there and be blue. The Uriel is going to do the diagonal attack and the straightforward one, as I was about to describe. Yeah, that was going to be the diagonal attack. You can tell which one he's going to do based on how many of his hands actually light up. If it's just one towards the center, that means that you've got the single target attack coming at you. If he holds both of his palms out, or both of his arms out to the sides, you know that the diagonal one is coming. And then for Gabriel, it's completely different. If you see both of the hands and both the arms out, they're going to be doing the cross attack, which is going to be in all four directions, not diagonal. And then he also has a separate attack, which is diagonal in front of him, but it's the same animation as Uriel's single target attack. Single beam attack, I should say. Maybe we'll get Cricket's head. We didn't, but we get a whole lot of money. Thank you, Rune Bag. What is this? Now just rune that got us hit because we knocked back that Isaac Aper turret. You know, the people are going to be asking, is this a one run? With Magic Mush here, it's almost a surefire win. The only thing that's keeping me from saying that is that we don't really have, like... Could I win on this run alone? Yeah, I could win with... We've won with much worse, for sure. It would be nice for us to get a premier synergy going. Maw of the Void would be excellent with this build. I wouldn't mind Athame, of course. We could do some Blackheart Bombing if we wanted to. But it's still... This run is still losable. I decided to do that because I don't want to lose a soul heart to these jerks. So we get double Ultra Pry, which is going to give us the left hand, which is fine by me. Left hand is going to convert all chest drops into red or dark chest, depending on what you call them. And four souls are called dark chests, so I'm going to call them dark chests, but I've also described them as cursed chests. We get X-ray specs again, which has been showing up quite often. I've got something in my eye. Excuse me. Like one of those, like, you ever get one of those eyelashes that just, like, fold up? It feels like it folds up underneath and, like, jabs you right in your pupil. There you go. Sorry about that. So X-ray specs are going to reveal, not only reveal, but also open up our... secret rooms and super secret rooms automatically, so we no longer have to spend bombs there. We did get our Algis rune back, which is great. We did get our Algis rune back, and that's great. Do we have a reroll machine here? We do. I will buy one more soul heart. I'm not going to use this bomb just because I don't really want to. We get red candle and coupon for the second time. How lucky. All right, so we'll head on up. But we got duality. We got X-ray specs. X-ray specs is great. Again, it's guaranteed access to the secret room, super secret room. Saves us the bombs that we normally would have spent in there and opens up a lot of potential. So a discussion that I wanted to have yesterday but couldn't because of just how everything was going in yesterday's run. Recently there was a birthday in the family, and I asked the person whose birthday it was. I said, "Hey, I don't really know what you want, so how about you just tell me what you want?" And they told me, and I bought it, and everything was great, and they were happy when they received it. They actually received it today, and it was awesome. That was probably debatably some of the worst damage of all time, but I also thought that I was far enough away from that barrel. So, I don't know. And it got me wondering. It got me wondering, would you... Because I already have an answer on this. I just want to poll the mosh pit. I want to see where you guys and gals feel. Like, where you guys, you know, sort of land in this conversation. It got me wondering, would you rather get something that you really, truly want... but no, it's not going to be a surprise? Or would you rather be surprised by something that you kind of wanted, but you weren't really sure like you were going to get. I'm always a big fan of the straightforward approach. I respect people who admit they just like, you know, I don't really know what you like. I'm not sure what you're into anymore. Whether it be, you know, a family member that you're not really that close with or you keep in contact with that often, but they still want to do something nice for you. I respect that more than if, like, they bought me something that, like, I casually mentioned that I'm like, oh, yeah, you know, Pokemon's really cool. I've always thought about getting some, but, like, you know, I'm kind of a Magic fan, too, now. And then, like, they buy me, like, Pokemon cards. You know what I mean? It's like, oh, thanks. Instead of them giving me a phone call, I'm like, hey, your birthday is coming up. You know, what would you like for your birthday? I think that after you get a certain age, there's no need for surprises anymore, you know? Like, once you turn, like, I don't know, probably, I'm going to say arbitrarily, let's say 26. There comes a time where it's just like, you know, it's just unnecessary. Now, one thing I will say, this is going to be a counter argument because I realize that some people are just going to say, well, why don't you just ask for money, or why don't you just give gift cards then? I would rather not get just straight up cash, because I'm not going to, because like if someone gives me cash, I'm not going to want to spend it. I'm just going to put it in the bank and then that's it. I'm not going to get anything for it, you know. So it feels like essentially you haven't gotten anything, and I'm not saying that to be ungrateful. I'm telling you, like, it's sort of like an out of sight, out of mind sort of thing. If someone says, well, I didn't know what to give you, so here's like $50 or whatever. I was like, oh man, thanks. But that's going straight in my bank account and like maybe paying for groceries. That's not special. You know, I would much prefer somebody just called me and said, hey, you know, I'm not really sure what you're into. I'm going to be honest, but I would love to get you a birthday present. What would you like? I would rather have that than the other two scenarios. One scenario being the aforementioned, like, you know, they do their homework and they heard you say something off, you know, just sort of like off topic or offhand, talking about you wanted something and then, you know, they got it for you. It's like, oh, wow, but you didn't like really, really want it, you know? Or, hey, I don't know what to get you here, just have some cash. That shows less effort than actually just calling me and saying, hey, what do you want? You know? And that way I know for sure I'm getting what I want. You know, this person is doing me the favor of ordering it and having it shipped here. Or if you don't live in a, you know, in a particularly connected area, then you could be like, oh yeah, they're gonna go pick it up for me and then bring it to me, you know, sort of thing. Like, that's awesome. I would much prefer that. And I would respect the person more too. That shows that they actually do want to take the initiative to get a meaningful birthday present instead of just saying, oh, here's a gift card for Amazon. You know, it's like, it, like, I would rather get cash instead of an Amazon gift card at that point. You know, like I think that gift cards, while it is a good idea, this is going to sound a little bit strange, but while it is a good idea to see, like, well, you're limiting their options to, like, make sure they get what they want by giving them, like, say, an Amazon card or a Best Buy card or, you know, name whatever business corporation you want. It's like, now I'm obligated to have to go use this. And you feel like a piece of trash for not doing it, like, if it just slips your mind. Because, like, the last thing that's on my mind on any given year, ever since like I've been old enough to drive, the last thing on my mind is, man, I can't wait to go pick up a birthday present for myself. You know, and when I get a gift card, something like that, unless if it's like an electronic gift card, then you know, whatever. But if someone gives me like a Best Buy gift card, it's like, well, now I got to go to Best Buy and go pick up what I want. Like, I would have been much happier and it would have been much simpler if you just asked me what I wanted and you could have brought it to me, because now I have to go get it. You know what I mean? Like, I know that sounds very snooty and stuff. I'm just letting you know. That's my thought process. I would never tell someone who did that. I would never say, like, oh, wow, thanks for the errand. You know, now I got to go run an errand. because you didn't bother to ask me what I wanted, and you know, I would never say that, but that's the thought process that goes through my mind. Maybe I'm just a terrible person. I don't know. I would respect the person a lot more if they just gave me money. Gift cards, like, I've got a perfect idea for a new video. It just struck me, and it's gonna be gold. I've already got it planned out. You know, but that's just like. Yeah, it's like, yeah, hey, thanks. But, you know, you really didn't have to. I don't really want the Outages rune. I don't know. People are going to be like, you should just be happy you're getting anything anyway. It's like, yeah, but that's not the point, though. Like, if I would rather, I'd rather get something that I wanted and that person give it to me rather than me having to go pick it up. I don't know. Like I said, maybe I'm just a terrible person. Possible, I suppose. I cannot believe that we've now laid two Bomber Boy bombs in here and not hit anything but ourselves. I really want to get rid of this HP, but I have a feeling that Krampus is going to be in there. Oh, mercy. I just had a feeling, man. Can I borrow a feeling? Erk Van Houten. Hello, darling. Godhead. It's been showing up with some rather alarming frequency. But I'm not going to complain about it. Did I go back and get Black Candle, by the way? I did not. That was the whole point of me going out to get money, was to get Black Candle, and I ended up not picking it up. I got two tunnel vision talking about my birthday gift stuff. Which, for the record, my birthday is not for another couple months, so... Yeah, don't worry, I'm not trying to project or trying to drop subtle hints. I'm far past that point in my life. I mean, at this point, if I just want something, I just go out and buy it, you know, or save up for it. Like a computer, for example, that I still have not gotten any information about. Cough, cough, Digital Storm. I'm not that upset about it. I'm not really upset. I'm a little annoyed. Only because they have... So, when you order something from Digital Storm, I'm only speaking through this one experience. When I ordered the new computer, I was contacted by Digital Storm, and they said, hey, we received your order, blah, blah, blah. And then I was contacted again. They said, hey, we got you. We're waiting for this and this and this. It's like, oh, cool. And on there, the reason why I'm bringing this up is right here. On that email, there is a truncated list, a bulleted list of when stuff is supposed to be done. And they give you an estimate, a rough estimate in business days of how long each stage is going to take. So stage two was supposed to take at most 3 business days. Stage one was supposed to take at most 2 business days. So I'm like, you know, they provided a time for when you can expect something, but then they don't adhere to it. And that may not be a big deal to people. You might be hearing that, you might be thinking like, well, why does that matter? Well, the thing is that the last time I heard from Digital Storm about my computer was 18 days ago. Which, you know, you don't have to be a mathematician to figure out that's almost 3 business weeks worth of business days. You know, that's almost three weeks worth, period. So, you know, I'm not upset about it. I'm just a little concerned. You know, so I sent them an email. So To continue this conversation, I sent them an email as I was talking about doing a couple days ago. I sent them an email this yesterday morning, which is now 2 days ago for you all. And I just said, hey, you know, this is my order number, blah, blah, blah. I haven't heard from you guys in, you know, 18 days. Oh, there's a mega troll bomb there. I did not know. I haven't heard from you all in 18 days, you know, just trying to see what's going on. Because there's a list of time, there's a timetable here that you all provided me that you have not adhered to. So, you know, I want to know if there's any problems with shipping or anything, payment, et cetera, et cetera. There shouldn't be a problem with payment because it's already, that money's already gone. And I haven't heard back from them. So now I'm getting to the point where, like, okay, if I don't hear back from them, like, by the time this Isaac video goes out today, and after I wake up, of course, like, we're gonna be like, hey, I'm gonna start, you know, tweeting at him, like, hey, you know, it would be cool if I could hear, like, some progress report or something about my computer. I mean, I did drop, like, a small fortune for this thing. You would think that someone who spent thousands and thousands of dollars would get a little bit more of a correspondence, you know. And even then, like, even by them not staying on their timetable, I'm actually not all that, like, frazzled about it. What I am frazzled about is the fact that I haven't heard back from them after emailing them, just asking, like, for an update. That's the part that I'm a little bit irked by. Because, I mean, like, essentially, I've dropped enough to buy, like, a pretty decent pre-owned vehicle, like, modern pre-owned vehicle. And my email has not been responded to yet, you know. And I think that I don't think it's that unreasonable for me to assume that as someone who's a paying customer sends an email, I should probably hear back from a response within 24 hours. I think that's reasonable, especially if it's not on a weekend. If it's on a weekend, then yeah, sure, I understand. But I sent this on a freaking Tuesday, you know, and now it's Thursday and I haven't heard from them yet. Technically Wednesday for me, Thursday for y'all, blah, 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 blah. You know what I mean. So if you follow me on Twitter, you know, you may have already seen the tweet. Maybe, maybe not. Like I said, it kind of just depends on when I wake up. Did a huge growth. No, thank you. Got a Yara rune. I'm okay with that Yara rune. You know what? I'm okay with it using that Yara rune right here. Super. Close. So close. We had it there. We're only one away from Guppy, by the way, because we used Guppy's paw. I don't think that's too unreasonable to expect. I don't think that that's being entitled. Modern day businesses usually have a 24-hour, at the very most 48-hour grace period whenever a customer sends in an email and can realistically expect a response. You know, but now it's been well over 24, or it's been well over 48 hours since I sent that that email. So, you know, again, I don't think I'm being unreasonable to have wanted to at least heard something back. So, and I've been in the past, I've always tried to avoid publicly calling out stuff like that. You know, and I'm not going to be nasty. I'm not going to be rude. But I am going to be a little bit snarky, being like, hey, Digital Storm, you know, I did buy, like, basically a pre-owned car from you. Just trying to get it'd be nice to get an update or something like that. A couple years ago, I would have never dreamed about doing anything like that, because, like, oh, no, you know, I gotta be respectful, gotta be professional. Answers. And what I've learned over the course of many, many years doing this and having that is that the old adage of the squeaky wheel gets the grease sort of adage, that is absolutely true in terms of getting what you want. As long as you're not being unreasonable. Again, it's all about that one little caveat there. You gotta be reasonable. But now, sometimes, of course, companies do unreasonable things that make absolutely no freaking sense. And hey, I'm all for calling out stuff like that. But you can't expect other companies to, like, you know, they promise you the moon and you only got like a rock or something like that. You know what I mean? Like, you gotta keep your expectations realistic. But I mean, that's how that, like, complaining about stuff, like, for, like, Comcast is a great example. When I used to be with Comcast, you know, complaining to them about connectivity issues and also belaboring the you know, the support sort of thing, so the support process that they had, and complaining about it on social media put me in contact with people who could actually get the job not only fixed but also improve the response time later on. And that's why, even with the stigma of Comcast, I never had a problem with Comcast ever. As soon as I complained about the connectivity issues and the tech that came over, he made it worse. I complained about it on social media. I was actually put in direct contact with somebody at Comcast who was able to help me out and was always there to hook me up if I had a problem. And my service never went down without prior warning. You know, the maintenance windows were very, very short. If I did have to get an on-site, a tech to come out, 68%, lol. Curse the Blind? Yeah, funny joke. Curse the Blind that. Come on, Left Hand. We only brought you on this road for one thing and one thing only, and that was for you to produce Guppy. And says, don't mind if I do. So, I'm not looking for... I'm hoping that... With all that said, I'm really hoping that Digital Storm ends up answering my email before I wake up tomorrow. / today. But I have a feeling they're probably not. Just call me kooky, call me crazy. I feel like if they were going to answer it by now, they already would have. Second time we've seen Curse the Tower. I'm not taking Curse the Tower because we don't have Polar Invincibility. We also don't have Sad Bombs. If we had Sad Bombs, I would consider taking Curse the Tower, but now it doesn't matter. Because we got Guppy. Burp, 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 burp. He's a stupid cat. Burp, burp, burp. Burp, burp. Hey. All right. Thanks for showing up, Bob's Rotten Brain. Rob's Rotten Head, I should say. Yeah, so, I mean, if you had any doubts about this run being a one run, it's been, as soon as, that question was answered as soon as we got Godhead. As soon as we got Godhead, this run got, if you know what I mean. I've always loved that saying. You're gonna get got. You know what I mean? so stupid. this one right here, they've got to get got. I heard that saying many, many times before I heard it in Breaking Bad and The Shield. And I've always laughed. Every single time, it's hilarious. Oh, blank card's pretty good. Oh, man. Now, piercing shots with Godhead tears. Whew. Brother, you want yourself a powerful, like, ultra combo right there? Godhead, Death's Touch. That is spicy. On top of all that, remember, we're Guppy, so, like, this run's only going to get crazier. So you're seeing there, we're doing considerably less damage with our tears when we can just let the aura kind of coast past Blue Baby. Old Hush here. Hushy got God. It was on this day that old Hushy, he knew he was going to get God. He was going to get gotten real good. I'm stupid. What a run. Yeah. Honestly, Burcano blank card's not terrible. Especially with this damage. Our damage is not like world-stoppingly awesome. It's good. Very good. Either one of those cards really matter. The question mark card is just going to use our spacebar item twice, and it's essentially useless with the blank card. It also takes you to the I Am Error room, I think, now that I think about it. Got Guppy's head here. Might be a Yara rune over here, which would be madness. They Hwaz. Oh yes, friends. We are taking AWAS. You already know why. You already know why. And if you don't, then you best call somebody. Another AWAS. Ooh. Be interesting. To a spades. Justice. Yara. I'm not gonna take Yara. I am going to say that we can, with this combo, we can pretty much practically guarantee a full house run. We haven't had a full house run in a while. The first full house run of 2020 is due. Because with this many stage skips, it is almost inconceivable that we won't be able to get at least one Delirium Portal. But of course, we have to go through a Victory Lap first. Now, I would not mind getting an Emperor card. That might be actually a little bit faster than AWAS, but we'll see. Okay. And we have ourselves a dead end here.
Drop the left hand, Invicta. Oh my god.
I mean, yeah, I guess we could drop the left hand. Good. It's a good point. It's a good point, Thrall. I will acquiesce. Like the Danny G and Brian Knee single of 2017, which was voted probably the worst song at the start of the Civil War. Well, I don't want to say the worst song. I think people widely consider Dan's delivery probably the worst out of the entire NLSS Civil War. The Golden Age. I feel like if there was ever going to be another one, which I'm sure there will be. By the way, that's a full clear on the right side. There's almost certainly going to be another NLSS Civil War. I would say that the next one will probably happen. If I had to choose, or if I not choose, but if I had to guess, like an educated guess, I would say probably this summer or next summer. Definitely the summer of 2020 or 2021. One of those two. And you can come back to this video, episode number 700 and whatever this is. You can come back and say that Sinvicta called it. And I already know the song I'm gonna parody. I already know it. I ain't gonna give it away, because if it does happen, then it's gonna happen. This is a full clear of the dark room, by the way. In case you wanted to see what this map looked like, for those of you playing along for yourself. Yep, there we go. Very nice. Very nice indeed. Very standard. Let the fun begin. Oh yes, friends. It's gonna be one of those. No, not one of those. So the reason why I was saying that you can practically guarantee a delirium kill here is because if we don't get a delirium portal in any of the next, I don't know, however many floors we end up going, we can just simply do another run and get a delirium fight. I'm determined to get the all kill. Not all kill, the full house run. Although I will say we do need to go get an angel statue so we can go fight Mega Stan. Sissy! How you doing, Sissy? How you doing, little Sissy? Who knew that we randomly decide to go into an errant item room only for our salvation and savior as we know it to be in there, Sissy? How you doing, Sissy? We don't even need anything else anymore. Welcome, Sissy. The crowd goes wild. Little Sissy Longlegs, the champion of the people. You know what? It's Curse of Lost. If we have to, we'll go back around again just to get the key. That's one thing I should have thought of was I shouldn't have taken both of the key pieces in the first lap, because it's going to be used, fired, if we end up doing another one here. So that was a little bit of an oversight by me, but who cares? Because we got Sissy. She's happy that we know that we're happy that she's here. She loves us for it. And if you're not having a good day, if it's not been going good for you, if you're not happy right now, Sissy still loves you. She's glad that you can assess your own mental health and express your own feelings. She's proud of you and she loves you. Even if you're unhappy, even if you're sad, Sissy still loves you. Sissy's here for you. Oh yeah, we do have duality, don't we? Here you go, Sissy. Go get him, little Sissy. How to make everybody mad. Take mom's knife, Godhead. Diamonds, no thank you. So we need to get our double deal here. Really hoping it was gonna be Emperor card. Because eventually we can't use AWOS anymore. I would not mind a little bit more damage. I know that seems kind of strange for us to even say, considering the fact we have Godhead. But more damage would be kind of nice. Because we don't, right now, like, we don't have, like, show-stoppingly amazing, awesome power damage. We've got, like, yeah, we're doing good damage, you know. But it's not, like, shut down, close all the schools, and alert the media type of damage, you know. We want something juicier here. So the only reason why I'm going to do this fight is because I want to make sure that we get an angel deal, if we can get one. And because we have duality, which is from our original run in this run. By the way, the seed for the second one. GMU 7 tip. Luck upgrade. Teratoma. Yeah, so we have kept our... Yeah, you know, we can take it. We've kept our duality from the original run. But the only problem now is that, and I guess I should have probably thought about this, is that if we don't get a devil, if we end up not getting a devil deal on this floor, we might be SOL, unless if we find a Joker card. And the reason why that is because I've taken the negatives, or I've taken the Polaroid, so that means that we cannot go down to do a victory lap again if we don't get the second key piece. So, should have probably thought about that, but... You know, there's probably a lot of things I should have thought about over the course of the last, I don't know, however long it's been. Let's say a day. Let's say there's probably a bunch of stuff I should have probably thought about today and didn't. But you know? Okay, so that at least allows us to get into the chest. Dark chest, that is. So the sacrifice room is there, and also the sacrificial room is going to be able to reduce the golden key force anyway. So even if we don't get an angel deal here, which is possible, we can still guarantee get the second key piece. That's the big point. That's the only thing that matters. Yep. And why would I leave that to a 68% chance? We all know that's zero. Yep, good old-fashioned Sinvicta luck. It is quite amazing, isn't it? What I'm doing right now is I'm trying to summon an angel to spawn here. There's Uriel. There we go. Now we can either get teleported into the devil deal, or we'll get taken to the dark chest. Dark room, which is not what I want. One thing I do want, though, is we're going to go see old Hushy. Old Hushy is going to get got again. And Sissy's proud of it too, Sissy. How you doing, Sissy? Yeah, I'll take Cancer. Cancer's going to give us a wafer effect should we take any damage. Maybe I should have taken chocolate milk, but who knows? Who really cares? Not me. We got Godhead and we got Sissy. That's all that we need, Sissy. All right, so we have a guaranteed delirium fight here. But that doesn't give us Mega Stanley for the full house run. Old Hushy got. He done got in this day. Curse of the Lost, hooray. There's a black rune in there, but don't really care. Item. Oh. Cracked crown is awesome. Okay, so we have ourselves a golden chest that has an item in it. Means all we need is a full charge on the ground anywhere, preferably close by, and we will be able to endlessly duplicate that. Here we go, sissy. Of course, all the items on the ground in that room are going to be problematic. To an annoying degree, but hopefully we just get a space bar, or we don't get a space bar, but hopefully we get a full charge, and that'd be it. Of course, I could also just, like, take a whole bunch of damage and recharge Blank Card Yera. But who's got that kind of time? Not me. I'm an important person on the internet. If you think that I'm being facetious, there are people who are like that. There are a great many of people who consider themselves an important person on the internet. I am not one of them. I don't tend to think of myself. Not in that light, or really any light. You know? There's a lot of self-glossing that goes on in the new media industry. Oh, we've never been in here before. My mistake, how could I have been so foolish? Please divulge one thing, game. Where is my full charge on the ground? Now, it is possible that all those may be little baggy, but if they are, we have a black rune ready to go. This is also severely cutting into our runtime here. The Hierophant. And a dead end. Just need one full charge on the ground. That's all we care about, really. Not a full charge. Reason why I'm going back here is just because, like, I don't want to waste the full charges that we've got in case we don't get any more full charges. But I'll end up probably stopping here because we really don't necessarily need to break the game. That is getting actually kind of later than I was expecting. Let's do this. Let's do Yera. Yera. Okay. I'm going to try to move some of those. Oh, man. Tammy's head's actually huge here. This is going to be a chore. There we go. Thank you, sissy. We're going to have to pick up Abel, unfortunately. Honestly, I could probably stand with taking Tammy's head. Goat head. The second little baggy. Second fate, or second rune bag. Frickin's head, I will happily take here. I will take Steven. Alright, if I can just get around you, excuse me a moment. Pardon me. Okay. Gonna have to use a bomb here for strategic bombing purposes. By that I mean putting it down and then running away like a scared puppy. I cannot move. I had to. I didn't want to get little baggy. That's alright, we have 55 damage now. Which is pretty good. Alright. Nothing to sneeze at, you know. Oh, yeah. All right. And we have spent the majority of this victory lap in the cathedral. I think we spent more time in this cathedral than we have on the actual run itself. See, now we've got the kind of knockout power, like, you know. Oh, that's a very funny game. Heard you need a full charge. There you go, loser. Oh, this is one big dead end too, huh? Yep. Oh, we got our AWOS rune back. And the search for the right way to go continues. Okay, well, it's going to be a dead end here. Let's I guess just try it down here again for the second time now. Maybe we got a place to go over here. No. Okay. Well. Yeah. This is definitely confirmed. Still a dead end. We have indeed gotten there, Isaac. Yep. No. That one's still a dead end too. All right. Maybe go up here. Maybe something. Something around here. Something need doings on over here. Something like that. No. Okay, well, we've already been over here, but maybe we can go check again here and go up. There's a Yara room. We got a second Yara room. Cheers for that. And first room. Oh, yeah, we've already been in there. Okay, well, it's... Well, there's a charge key in there that I forgot about, but, you know, they people get forgetful sometimes. Yeah, you know. And, yeah, this is going to still be a dead end down here. All right. We could just, find the right way to go. That'd be really cool right now. That'd be super duper. Okay, well, again, we've already confirmed that this is not the right way to go, Isaac. So thank you for showing up and demonstrating to us that this is potentially the wrong way to go. And we've been in this room already. Here, it's just inspecting the territory. You know, just making sure that everything is still kosher and still caught up and looking fine. Just the way that we left it last time, Isaac. There we go. Okay. Jesus Christ, get me the hell out of this run. yeah. Yeah, your boy is done. I'm pleased that we get a good run here. There's Dad's key, so it turns out all that fuss that we were kicking up about not having a key piece didn't matter in the end. $2 bill is kind of not a smart move, but with 55 damage, you know, we've got quite the show-stopping spectacle of a run. Looking for a delirium portal now. That's not a delirium portal. Our hopes and dreams now lie with Stanley. All right, Stan. Aww.